talk, deaths per terawatt hour. This talk will be held in English. The talk will be held in German. The translation, of course, which you are listening to right now, is in English, but we can expect a lot of English slides, fortunately. And the talk will be about what the ideal energy mix is for our future. Our speaker is a nuclear physicist. And please give her a warm round of applause. Have a nice evening and welcome to Zeninik. So the town of Zeninik, where we are right now, has a population of only 13,000 people. And if you think about what typical Germans consume per day, and you multiply that by the population of Zeninik, you see that that it's like 243 kilowatt hours. And I have put all the sources for my talk into the footnotes. So 243 kilowatt hours. So unfortunately, I don't see you guys because it's so dark here. Because usually I like to ask questions to the audience, and I don't know if you guys think that this is a lot or not so much. So if you think of a nuclear power plant, it's like 1-point-something gigawatts. So I don't know how much you consume. Of course, everyone has like an electricity bill. So, for instance, I consume also like quite a bit. And so the numbers that I'm using here are, of course, like averages. If you look at the camp, then this camp has a population size of roughly 5,000 people. We have 6 generators generating electricity, and the average across the last couple of days was like 300 kilowatt hours. That means that this camp by itself consumes more energy than the entire town of Zeninik, where we are right now. So this is a lot. C3 Power has a nice monitoring tool that I've shown here. This shows like the amount of fuel that's being burned per hour. And I looked at the showering area where people and I looked at the times when not a lot of people were actually showering, and it's still a lot. And if you have like on average 12 liters of fuel for heating, what does it actually mean? So for instance, also for my own home, which is quite old, so if we only take the shower village, the 5 days of the camp consumes as much fuel as 2/3 of my household the entire year. The population of Zeninik is about 30% bigger just by this camp. And the energy consumption has risen by 120%. And yeah, where does the energy consumption actually come from? Of course, we have energy, so we have light. But also people use hair dryers, even under these conditions. So should people still use this? And I don't know if people heat electrically or with burning things. And this camp,
4 mal 10 hoch 4 Tote zusätzlich nur
causes about 4 to the power of 10 of minus 4 in addition to what we would normally have produced. At 10 to the power of 4 deaths is definitely is too much.
Basierend auf dem Energieverbrauch.
And this is all based on other data that I have. Germany uses about 520 terawatt hours. So if you look at the individual sectors for 2017, you see the different fractions, and also the source at the bottom is the same source for the next slide, which we see here. So this is the current energy mix. About a third is coal, and we have like one third regenerative energy. So doesn't sound too bad, but you know, one third of coal is still bad. And yeah, so this is actually a lot of dirty energy that we have. And then we do what physicists usually like to do, it's doing thought experiments. We can create an energy supply for this country that is ideal, and we can basically decide what we want in this thought experiment. We only talk about infrastructure and how to. We're not talking about how to transition the current infrastructure to the new infrastructure, just from scratch. So now we have to define some things. So what is actually optimal? So is it cost? Do you care about the cost? Do you care about CO2 emissions, or do you care about people dying? And then the second definition that we need is energy sources. So it doesn't really make sense for a state like Austria to say, okay, we're going to produce all of our electricity from offshore wind. And based on these things, I have listed these energy sources for our thought experiment. So coal, gas, nuclear, solar, wind, hydropower, and oil is not really a big factor in Germany. So I didn't include this because it doesn't really matter, and also Germany doesn't have big oil reserves. Biomass I did not include, even though it is used to some degree in Germany, but there's simply not enough data or the right type of data that for me to work with. And there's geothermal energy, which is something that just doesn't work with the German geography. So our variables are coal, gas, nuclear, solar, wind, and hydropower. These are the six that we want to use. So what do we want to optimize? We can look at the price. We can optimize the emissions. So what is cheap but also has low emissions? Availability is a factor. If you don't have oil, then it doesn't make sense to use oil as a resource. Or hydropower is a classical example. So in Austria, it works because you have many faults, many rivers, which doesn't work in Germany, because in Germany we have like just 4% of hydropower right now, because there's simply not enough rivers and mountains. Then there are also external costs, which is a bit diffuse, or it sounds a bit diffuse. So everything that is basically collateral damage like Fukushima or Chernobyl. And of course, like CO2 in the air that causes people to die, or any other catastrophes or.
Und nicht zuletzt Emotionen.
And the last factor is emotions.
Echt richtig.
And emotions are actually quite important.
Diesen ganzen Themenbereich, weil
they are important because nuclear power is evil and wind power is good. How is this? You can ask yourself, how is this actually defined? And we can look at the data and see how people perceive certain sources of energy.
LCOE, das heißt auf Deutsch Stromgestehungskosten.
So if we want to measure the price, we can use the LCOE, which is the levelized cost of energy. And so if you take coal, then of course you have to mine the coal first. Or if you have nuclear power, then of course you need the right materials for the atomic splits. But this definition does actually not include these aspects. It only cares about the construction of a power plant and the running of the power plant. But in principle, these costs. Yeah, so this is just for having something to compare the different forms of energy with each other. And yeah, so there are actually quite complex formulas, but in the end, the most important part is to be able to compare different energy sources.
Stromgestehungskosten beinhalten nicht die Ressourcen, die man dazu braucht, also quasi.
So these formulas do not include the resources that you need to get everything run. So the decommissioning, so when a power plant is no longer being used. Yeah, and if you look at nuclear waste, so you have to ask yourself, okay, is this something that you should include? Well, maybe.
Diese Stromgestehungskosten.
The power creation or power generation costs come from this study.
Auch kein Hydropower. Das sind die Zahlen, die ich genommen.
And this does not include hydropower.
Da geht es um den Unterschied, ob man das aufs Dach macht oder.
But it talks about solar power and if it makes a difference where you actually put the solar panels, so on the roof or somewhere else.
Und das gleiche dann irgendwie für Wind.
And they also looked at wind energy. So they looked at the differences between offshore and on land installations of windmills, of wind turbines. And you see that it's actually quite an effort to put these up.
Das andere Gasnetz, das ist aus der Leitung quasi aus Russland kommt, die haben wir.
And different types of gases have also different types of costs for production. And these are the data points that are used for the generation of, so for the calculations. The second point is emissions. There is a measure called CO2 EEQ. And so this does not only include CO2, but also other related carbon oxides. And different gases are differently damaging to the climate and have different global warming effects. And in the end, you still have to basically account for every factor and make them comparable.
This is IPCC, this is Intergovernmental Climate Change or
so. So here's another data source from the IPCC from 2014, where they tried to compare the CO2 EQ values.
Technologien ändern sich und Technologien.
But technologies change. And some newer technologies emit less CO2. And therefore these data points are dynamic.
CO2-Äquivalent verwendet habe für mein Modell, das sind die hier.
So, yeah, this is what I used for my model.
Klar war im Endeffekt, wenn man sich mal einfach mit Hausverstand überlegt.
So if you just look at this, then you see that coal is actually quite seducing.
Nicht überraschend auch, dass Kernkraftwerke im Endeffekt nicht viel CO2 neutral.
And you of course you also see that nuclear plants don't produce much CO2, but they have other problems.
CO2 ist keins davon. Externe Kosten sind
so external costs are a very complex but also very interesting topic.
Dass es ein riesen Konglomerat an Faktoren ist, die da einwirken.
So there are many different factors that have to be taken into account.
Auf die ich dann nachher komme, die
there are models that I will talk about later.
Definiert ist es so, dass man sagt, so jemand, der nicht verantwortlich ist für etwas, was passiert, aber die Kosten oder eine Benefit davon tragen muss oder kann. Ja?
So it's
also zum Beispiel die
defined like this. So the people who are responsible for it might actually not suffer the consequences, but other people might suffer the consequences, and then these are external costs. And the polluter does not carry the costs, but it's actually the people who are affected by it.
So,
for instance, people who are swept away by tsunamis or by other natural disasters caused by global warming.
Auch ein schönes Thema sind diese Beyond Insurance Accident Effects. Ne? Also
and there are also Beyond Insurance Accident Effects.
400.000 Toten, solche Sachen.
So things that are simply not covered by any insurance. Things that can only be covered by any action that a government can take care of.
Für uns ist irgendwie Wasserkraft was ziemlich sicheres. Ne?
And then there are of course emotions. So for ourselves we consider hydropower a very safe technology.
Also es ist nie irgendwie ein Nachbarort oder keine Ahnung.
But it's not something that's so for instance because there was never much of a dam break where a lot of people drank because there was never such a thing, such a catastrophe. But there are actually quite a lot of dam failures across the world.
Ort, den ich noch nie gehört habe vorher. Ich habe auch den das ist
one example is in China.
Das ist jetzt, was da ganz unten sehen mit den 171.000 Toten.
So at the very bottom of this table there is yeah, there were a lot of deaths and we in the Western world did not really notice much of this event.
Dammbruch war ein Resultat vom Taifun Nina 75.
And that dam break was actually a result of the tsunami
Und ich habe davon noch nie gehört.
Yeah, and I never heard of this event before.
Aber das ist so Emotion.
But this is emotions.
Wir kennen es halt nur sicher.
Yeah, is it safe? Yeah, well, we Westerners only know it as a safe technology. This is my favorite slide.
Das ist Verfassungs. Das ist ein Teil von der Verfassung von der Republik.
So this is part of the Constitution.
Also Atom hat. Es gibt keine Atome in Österreich, ne?
So this says that there is no atomic energy in Austria.
Die mögen wir halt nicht, die Atome, ne? So, die Zahlen, die
so, yeah, we Austrians don't like atoms.
Tote, die kommen aus einem Report von Paul Scherer.
So, this talks about 23,000 deaths that come from a report.
Das ist nur Tschernobyl, was da steht.
And this is just Chernobyl.
Dieser offizielle Body Count von 31 ist natürlich völliger
Bullshit. That's the official count, which of course is total bullshit.
Leute, die an Strahlenkrankheit gestorben sind.
This is just the direct casualties.
Drei Jahren quasi nach dem Incident. Entschuldigung, in den letzten drei Wochen nach dem Incident. Und dann halt auch diese ganzen Sachen, wie viele Leute haben, wie viel Doping bekommen.
So, but this does not include any follow-up deaths and illnesses, including leukemia cases.
Aussagen darüber treffen, weil es lange genug her ist.
And
Exposition,
at this point, we could do long-term effect evaluation.
auftaucht in den Statistiken. No?
But it doesn't really show up in any statistics.
Das nicht unbedingt bekannt war für Transparenz.
But then again, it happened in a country that was not really well known for transparency, and we would probably never know how much or how many people died directly or indirectly because of the incident.
Tausend-Seiten-Report oder sowas. Aber es gibt dann, ich habe mal sogar die Seite aufgeschrieben, glaube ich. Genau.
Yeah, so I noted down the site.
Seite 276 und
so page 276 from this report.
Diese Exclusion Zone verlassen mussten.
So these are also the people, so the 135 refugees, so 135,000 refugees had to leave the exclusion zone. But this is only Chernobyl, this does not include Fukushima.
Fremantle Island gab es keine Toten, also nachweislich wirklich keine. Es gab Schaden und alles,
and
aber keine Todesfälle, weil die Evakuierung gut gelaufen ist.
Yeah, but I mean, if you consider that in some cases the evacuation went really smoothly, people got iodine tabs. So the casualties were not as extreme, but they still happened. So again, which factors do we want to optimize? So we want to optimize the price, we want to optimize the emissions. So in general, so we want to keep these low. So availability, we don't care about it right now.
Was Hydropower hat, hat irgendwie so eine, also Wasserkraft hat eine gewisse Limitierung in Deutschland.
And of course, yeah, we know that hydropower has some limitations in Germany, but I don't want to talk about emotions.
Aber erstmal in diese ganzen Gleichungen.
But all of.
Also sie sollten nicht eingehen.
Yeah. So we don't want to include this in the equations.
Wir sollten denn doch basierend auf dem entscheiden, was gut für die Umwelt ist, was gut für uns ist.
Make our decisions based on what is good for us, what is good for the environment, and what is cheap.
Optimiertes Team.
So it should be optimized.
Darüber haben wir schon gesprochen. Das kann
we talked about that already. We can skip this. External costs.
Ich bin am 13.
I already experienced these. I went to Japan in 2011.
Vom Verteidigungsministerium in Österreich. Wir haben links da irgendwie im Rucksack habe ich drin komplettes mobiles eine Gammaspektrometrie.
We have some gamma spectrograph.
Fliegen wollten ohne zu wissen, wo sie hinfliegen. Die Austrian und
in the backpack there. Austrian airline didn't want to fly there.
Nach den drei Tagen,
so there were just a few airlines that flew there. We just flew there. We didn't know what will be there. There was no info from TEPCO, from anyone. So we had a lot of iodine.
Yeah, also we have.
So we had
a
nice colorful spectrum. So this was a grocery store in Japan. All the milk, all the dairy products were removed. So about these external costs, there are two good studies. For example, subsidies and cost of EU energy. It uses a second source. It's a report of the European Commission.
Ich glaube nicht, dass es irgendjemand hinkriegt, außer du nimmst dann ein Jahr oder zwei oder so Zeit, das wirklich aufzuarbeiten.
It's almost impossible to read it all. There are some executive summaries, but you wonder, is this what the data says or is this what you want me to think?
So, da gibt's einen Anspruch, der
how they did it,
also man geht dann quasi,
there's something called impact pathway.
Und
you think about what does the power plant emit, how does that interact with humans, plants and so on. So and then there's the pathway and we ask ourselves how likely is it. So either it's costs that you can actually put a price on, or there's deaths. And this is very sad.
Es ist nämlich so, dass externe Kosten werden normal sind nicht in Tropen pro Terawattstunden beziffert, sondern
so usually they are not accounted for in Euro, in deaths per terawatt hour, but in deaths per terawatt hour. So they actually
Verletzung von den Menschen, also der wird krank, der kann nicht mehr arbeiten.
They actually transform the deaths per terawatt hour to euro per terawatt hour. So, for example, if someone can't work anymore, then you just put a number on that. So, or if he dies, then you put a number on that.
Wie viel Tote pro Terawattstunde, welche Energieform?
So for the
muss man echt wirklich, und das habe ich versucht.
So for getting the numbers of deaths per terawatt hour, you have to go into the depths of the second report. So then we go to the table of contents and look at the, for the right page. Then we go to, then we see a little table, very small, on a big DIN A4 page, and there's the data. So when we do this, we don't, we can't only think about how many people die when coal is transported or so on, but we also have to think about very rare events like for example, in nuclear power plants like Chernobyl.
Aber Gauss gibt's ja auch bei Windkraftwerken, wenn so ein
Windkraftwerk. Such bad accidents also happens, can happen for wind power. So there's two different kinds of wind turbines. So when that starts to burn, then the fire department comes, but the fire department can't do anything, can only watch. So the cost there is the fire department and the someone, you need to pay someone to remove the debris and so on. But that's basically everything. The report analyzes all of these data for the different energy sources and does so very accurately. So, these are the results for the extern E studies. They were summarized by Staffeld and Wigdahl, Swedish researchers, doing that for a Polish conference. They did it for the Swedish. For the Swedish government to think about whether to turn off power plants or not. So what we see here is that oil has the most deaths per terawatt hour. So we see 80 deaths per terawatt hour in France. We have 520 terawatt hours in Germany. So these are really numbers that have some effect. So I took these numbers for the analysis later on. So let's go back to our thought experiment, whether there's a optimal energy mix that optimizes price, emissions and external cost.
Das heißt, wir können jetzt hergehen und optimieren.
So we can now optimize this and you. So now we have the factor matrix. The sources are the ones I mentioned before. These are the hard numbers. I'll upload the slides afterwards because I didn't want to ruin the surprise. So the variables are coal, nuclear hydropower, gas, solar, wind, all everything terawatt hours. So constraints that we have is that we need at least 520 terawatt hours.
Die Rahmenbedingungen, Entschuldigung. Und wenn man dann nur auf Kosten optimiert, also sagt,
so if we only optimize for cost, if we don't care about emissions and deaths, then we get this.
Das ist alles überraschend, weil halt irgendwie
this is not very surprising, because hydropower is just the cheapest one. But we only have a maximal capacity for hydropower of 21 terawatt hours, so we need another constraint. Hydropower is smaller or equal to 21 terawatt hours. So the next result is we get 21 terawatt hours hydropower and 499 terawatt hours nuclear power. This is only a price optimization.
Kernkraft ist die zweitbilligste Technologie.
So nuclear power is the second cheapest one, and it's quite logical, this result. So if we now look at cost and CO2 emissions, then we still get the same numbers, because nuclear power has a zero cost in the Department of CO2 emissions. So
for das ganze Methan raus. Deswegen haben die keine neutrale CO2-Bilanz.
That's so the other Methan, aber ist ja egal. So the other sources don't have that. So let's look at the metrics again.
Nuklearenergie, und wenn man sich die
so if we look at it,
5 Euro Cent pro Kilowattstunde und CO2-Emissionen, ja,
5
und 12 Gramm CO2-Äquivalent.
5 and 2 cents per kilowatt hour and CO2 12 and something else. I found that quite interesting.
So if we add
the deaths per terawatt hour,
Kohle hat mit Abstand die meisten.
Then we see that coal has the most.
Nuklear hat 2, Wasserkraft
2, hydropower has 1, solar power has 1, but it's pretty expensive right now. Why is it hours for nuclear power share
okay. gesagt, das wird nicht ordentlich gemacht.
And I mean, of course, we can still do it better. I mean, I am a nuclear physicist, so I know what I'm talking about, but I might also be a bit biased. But I still think that there's still a lot of potential for improving how we handle nuclear power. But the question is, what is actually important? What do we want to optimize? What are the focus? What is the focus that we should put on? Do we need to look at the cost? Do we need to look at what about the motions? Should we look about the cost? What, or do we care about what is on the electricity bill? Thank you very much. You will find me at the Chaos Balcony at Milliways. On Twitter, I'm Julia Riede. And yeah, thanks for the Beamer template. Oh, it's hardly see anything with the darkness. So if you have questions, it's really hard to see you in the audience.
Vielen Dank, Julia.
Thank you very much, Julia.
Bitte an den Mikrofon im Saal.
Please go to the microphones.
Da gibt es freundliche Menschen für. Ansonsten kann man auch online Fragen stellen.
But you can also ask online.
Wir haben noch knappe 2 Minuten für Fragen.
On IRC, we have about 2 minutes for questions.
Jawohl, bitteschön.
Danke. Mich würde interessieren, was passiert,
I would like to know,
bei den Kosten eigentlich von A bis Z alles mit einrechnen, mit Entsorgung,
if we include the full cost with disposal, with CO2 emissions. So, yes, it is. So the study does include some of the data, but it takes time. But it really takes time to research everything.
Aber es ist schon so, dass man richtig graben muss.
But you really have to dig deep to get all the data. And yeah, it's really. And sometimes you only have data from the 90s.
Man kann die natürlich suchen.
And the data is not really in a format that makes it easy to search.
Da kann man diese Preise wirklich ausrechnen. Aber ich kann's nicht.
But I'm unfortunately not able to do this digging.
Vielen Dank für die Antwort.
Thank you for Vielen the Dank. Answer.
Signal Angel, du hast eine Frage aus dem Netz, bitteschön.
Question from the internet.
Okay, I have a question. The price per energy for the nuclear power is
the price per energy for nuclear power.
Is this included?
Does this include the waste?
Okay.
I told you it's not included because it does not. It's not part of the formula that I used. And therefore, it does not include it. So it does not include the waste disposal and the accidents that are connected to the disposal.
Have you an estimation what it would cost like if it were properly done?
I have no idea. I have no idea. That's my honest answer.
You
could theoretically calculate it if you spend 1 to 2 years and dig for good data sets.
Can possibly calculate all these things, but it's not possible within a month or two.
But it's definitely not something you can figure out in a month or two.
But I couldn't do it in this time frame, so I don't know.
Yeah, so ultimately I don't know.
Yeah.
Vielen, vielen Dank für deinen
Vortrag. Thank you for the talk. And a round of applause. Ihr hörtet den Vortrag Deaths per Terawatt Hour. And